Are you ready to dance?
You're on the road to High School Musical 2.
We're back. I feel like we're back home. We're back where it all began. And it's a fantastic feeling.
We're so excited to be back with everybody. It feels like the first time again.
We're back here in Utah for High School Musical 2. It feels great to be back here together as a family again, you know? It's that camaraderie, that High School Musical energy that was there last year. It's back again now, and it's just really exciting.
It's cool being in the studio with everybody again, you know? Last time was my really, you know, my first time in a recording studio. It's all about trying to get your voice to sound the best in a certain song. And sometimes that takes a few tries. You have to feel out a number, feel out a song. I sang you words I never said, and it was easy.
Because you see the real me as I am. My favorite part about recording is being in there singing, just experimenting and having fun. Nice to be doing it again.
The recording process for this movie actually went really, really quickly. But the music, in my opinion, is so good that it was just kind of easy. Easy to just, you know, get in there and let it out.
There's a pressure for the follow-up, especially after the first one going quadruple platinum. Like, that doesn't happen very often. I'm dumbfounded right now just thinking about it. It just doesn't happen.
I think the music is really, really good, and I think even better than the first one. So, you know, we're all trying to step it up. Hopefully we can live up to what we did in the first one. This is where our summer begins.
The best part of the recording process for this was that I didn't really get to record in High School Musical 1. No solos or anything, that it was all group things, so I was never actually in the recording studio. So the fact that I actually get to be a part of the whole recording process for High School Musical 2 is pretty fun. I definitely think this soundtrack is going to connect with the audience. I know I connect to the music more, and I've heard other people connect to the music more, so I'm hoping that that's going to be the case.
The first one, we had no clue, no idea that it was going to reach so many people. High School Musical was the first time that I had ever stepped foot in a recording studio. What was so important about that album was the message and, you know, the soul and the heart that that we put into it. Everybody up, everybody rockin', take it from the top. I really hope that we can do the same with this one. I gotta say what's on my mind. Something about us doesn't seem right these days. Life keeps getting in the way. I think that the songs will definitely connect with the audience like the last movie, just because I think the things that we are going through are things that kids really do go through. What about us? What about
music will definitely connect with the audience. And the choreography that goes with it is gonna be incredible.
Here we go, do this.
Of course, we show up and Kenny has us, like, the day we get here, rather than resting or figuring things out and unpacking, we're dancing.
When these kids step into a rehearsal, they are 100% there. They just happen to all really be passionate young, you know, actors and musical performers who really are invested in the work. Watch it once more from 7, 8, 1, 2, jump 3 and 4. 5, 6, 7, touch 8.
We're moving, I feel like, at a pace that starts where the last one ended. And we're just coming in every day. We're doing hours and hours of rehearsal already. And then this morning, Corbin and I got together to do some of our partner work so that we're ready to come back to rehearsal because we understand that this one's gotta be a little bit better. We have to, you know, turn it up a little bit.
I love pair dancing. It's so fun being able to work off of another person. I mean, when you're working with someone else, you can look into their eyes and laugh or give the biggest smile, and it will make that person happy too. You kind of just feed off of each other.
Vanessa's my partner, so like, I get to look over at Vanessa and in the middle of the dance, she'll have like a big old smile on her face, and it sort of makes me forget I'm dancing for a second.
Great, everybody. Thank you. Here we go. We're off. We're running. We're doing it.
Hey, 1G! 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 1G!
It was a dream come true to even hear that they were excited about making the third movie. After you leave it for a while, you really crave this feeling to come back and be with your friends again and be creative on a daily basis. You know, it just rocks your world.
We know that we're the best team.
Boys, come on, boys, come on.
The way we play tonight is what we...
Us doing it as a feature gives us so much more opportunity to explore and create and do so much more than we did with the first two.
T-E-A-F-T. Gotta work it out, turn it on. Come on. This is the last time to get it right.
The musical numbers in this movie are amazing. They're just huge. It somehow does top the last two.
This is the last chance to make up.
This is quite an epic musical. We're having a good time.
This is the last game, so make you count it. Now or never.
We got some big numbers coming up, lots of singing, lots of dancing.
I think between all that, we're stepping it up.
Honestly, when we all get together, it's just magic. You know, we come back, we walk through the doors of East High School, and we see where it all began, and then to see where we are now and how far we've come is incredible.
What are we gonna be?
I felt like we needed to come back, we needed to finish the chapter.
I'm very excited about the music. The bar has been raised. It's going to be an absolutely fantastic winning soundtrack. It serves the story, it serves the characters. I'm really excited about it.
Getting ready, get ready, getting ready, ready,
get ready,
getting ready, getting ready, go.
We're raising the bar in a lot of different ways, man. We got tons more music.
What should I do with my hair?
Where's my shaver?
Ooh, I love it.
I look like a waiter.
Should I fluff it? It's getting later, already should be there.
I think the songs are a lot better.
A mother opens the door.
The songs move the story along, and each one has its own purpose.
It's time, the hour's up right.
Don't know why, but father's staring me down.
Where's my purse?
I think the songs have gotten better over the course of this process. And also, I think the songs have really become another character in this film.
It's gonna be a night.
Oh, yeah.
I love
love all the songs in all the movies, but like each time we do it, I'm like, oh my gosh, this is even better than last one. One of my favorites is a song called Right Here, Right Now. It's a really great number, just about being in the moment. The waltz between Zach and Vanessa is probably one of the most beautiful pieces in the film, and they looked amazing.
For the first time in High School Musical history, I got to dance with Zac Efron. We were doing the waltz, and he sang to me full out, and I literally felt like I was gonna pass out. I was like, wow. And I turned to him and I said, this is a moment that every girl would dream about.
Scream is like all of Troy's angst and confusion coming to a head, you know, at this moment in his life. And he doesn't know what he wants to do with his future.
It's the story of Troy trying to figure things out. And he's just trying to find himself. He's trying to figure out what he wants to do. I'm really, really proud of Zac Efron, not only as a dancer, but as an actor, but he's just raised his game so much.
Really like a wrap-up of all the three movies that we've done, saying, you know, we're moving ahead and we don't know what it's going to be like, but it's kind of, you know, we always want High School Musical in our life.
High School Musical, let's celebrate where we come from, the friends who've been there all along, oh yeah. High School Musical, who says we have to let it go, it's the best part we've ever.
Hey guys, I got a surprise for you.
We rock on. Mitchie is a very down-to-earth girl. Her mom raised her right. Music is her life. And she goes to camp because she wants to learn more about music and to fit in a little. I'm similar to Mitchie. We got the same haircut. No. We both play guitar and piano. I spend most of my time writing songs. It's like a therapy for me, you know, whenever I'm having a bad day. Just to express what I'm feeling like, you know? And we both write about stuff like that.
I learned to play instruments around the age of 10 and 11. I started playing a piano first and then moved over to the guitar, and my dad's a great teacher.
Every time I think I'm closer to the heart, what it means to know just who I am, I think I finally found a better place to start.
Sometimes it was tough incorporating choreographed moves. Other times it wasn't so bad. It depends, you know, it all takes practice, like anything. Like playing guitar or singing, you have to practice, make perfect.
I'm really weird when it comes to recording. I don't really do too much like vocal exercises before I go into the studio. So the whole day up until that point where we record vocals, I'll be singing the song, so it's pretty much already warm. But one thing that I do that's really weird that most people don't do because they think like dairy's bad for the voice is I eat chocolate right before I sing, and it makes it all like good. I sing great, it's hilarious. It's true.
That song, Who Will I Be, I think embodies the core of the movie, particularly when you connect it to the arc of her, Mitchie's final song, This Is Me.
This is real, this is me, I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be now, gonna let the light shine.
My own ad-libs, you know, vocal tricks that I wanted in there. It was kind of like getting to paint a picture that was kind of already painted. They gave you an idea and you get to elaborate and use colors and make the canvas complete. And so that's what I just did. I added my own stuff. You know, it was exciting.
Spread yourself around where you're, you know, I want to be a dancer, singer, actress, juggler, tight walker, you know, it's like tightrope walker, you know. Focus on, say if you can sing really well, focus on singing. If you can play guitar and sing, do that, you know? With us, we've really focused in on it, and we've been able to advance from place to place. Like Nick and me and Joe all play different instruments. You know, Nick goes drums to keyboards to lead sings to guitar to piano to percussion all during one single show. And that adds for a great experience. And you know, I'm lead guitar. I've really focused in on that thing. So practice your heart out. Give it your best and don't give up.
You're the voice I hear inside my head. The reason that I'm singing, I need to find you. I gotta find you. You're the missing piece. I need the song inside of me. I need to find you. I gotta find you.
Do a duet with somebody that I thought. Like, I loved the Jonas Brothers. I mean, I still do, obviously. But to hear my voice and his voice together, like, was like, wow, you're making it. And it was like a dream come true. Let alone, you know, the whole movie and my voice on those soundtracks was like, is that me? So I was really excited.
Six lots of practice to get to final jam.
We get to perform in our own way. Like, we do what we do, but we're with everyone else. So it's really cool because it's like you got this rock and roll aspect, but with all these amazing dancers behind you. So it's kind of cool and something we're starting to toil with because we're kind of getting used to it. So you never know what you could see in future performances and things like that.
my work is my play, for sure. We have so much fun what we do, and we'll never regret it, you know? Being on stage is one of the most fun things you can possibly think of. I think I'll never regret it, you know? I think people want to be rock stars because it's something cool to do, and like, people know who you are everywhere, and it's like, it's just fun to travel the world and see what's up.
Rock on!